Right, now we're in trouble. It's only just beginning.
Right, welcome to the Tin Dog Podcast. Before I do begin, I just want to send my best wishes to Tony from the WhoCast, who isn't particularly well at the moment. Get well soon, Tony. And also sending my best to Trevor, who's managing to trudge on, regardless of being there almost all alone. Right, before I talk about the DVDs that are coming our way very shortly, let's talk about the elephant in the room. And by which I mean, of course, David Tennant's departure. Well, the announcement. Tell you what, here's David to tell you all about it himself.
Well, I think when I first started back in 2005, I always thought that if it worked out, 3 years would be about the right time, the right amount of time to do 3 years, three series, which I did and I loved and I had a great time. And then there was the possibility of doing a few more, doing a few specials, which will see us through next year. So that was sort of too hard to turn down, really. And then, you know, I just had to start thinking about, was this the right time to move on? And Russell T. Davies is leaving, and Julie Gardner, the executive producer, are leaving. And my connection to the show had always been very linked to them. We did Casanova together, which was a BBC drama that really led to me doing Doctor Who. So that became a kind of natural stepping off point for me. What became very difficult is then when it was announced that Steven Moffat was taking over as the showrunner on Doctor Who, because I'm such a fan of his. He's such a great writer. He's written such amazing stories for me in Doctor Who already, that the prospect of hanging around for a while and enjoying working with him on it was sorely tempting and very nearly changed my mind again. But I thought, no, hang on, this is what I always thought I would do. This feels about right. And he was doing well and people seem to like it, and I think it's better to go when there's a chance that people might miss you than to hang around and outstay your welcome, I think.
And so we'll be able to say goodbye to our favourite 10th Doctor. And I, for one, will miss him. We've had some fantastic stories since this series came back, but let's not say goodbye just yet. The guy is here for a host of extras. Now, I have this theory, and after reading Russell T. Davies' book, I haven't been proven wrong about this theory yet. We've got 5 specials. And we're calling them 5, but let's face it, 2 of them are taken up with Christmas, which leaves us with 3 Doctor Who stories. Now, in Russell's book, he talks about 1 perhaps at Easter and 1 perhaps over Halloween, which next year falls on a Saturday, leaving 1 more, which probably takes place 2010, Easter, which will mean that Tennant's been officially in the role for 5 years, the same length of time as Pertwee. But more importantly, Easter's when Doctor Who usually returns to us. So does this mean that the 2010 series is actually being moved? Is it going to the place I always thought Doctor Who should be, which is the autumn schedules, or as you may say across your side of the pond, fall? It's not like you call spring bud, but let's leave it there. Doctor Who works best when it's dark. The audience figures will go up, and you'll be able to feed it straight into the Christmas run. So perhaps 2010 doesn't take place at the beginning of 2010, but closer to the middle or even the end. But that's 2010. We've got lots of stories lined up between then and now, all with our beloved 10th Doctor. So let's not cry just yet. Anyway, let's discuss the Series 4 DVD box set.
Wibbly wobbly, timey wimey.
And so November is upon us. And with November comes another Doctor Who DVD set just in time for Christmas. Ah, yes, Christmas, that time when you can ask for reasonably expensive things. And this is a reasonably expensive thing. 6 DVDs, things you've already seen, and possibly already own if you bought the vanilla versions, all in a nice, shiny box. If you buy them from various different suppliers like Amazon or Play.com, you'll get a variety of different types of packaging, some with Davros, some with free postcards, and others, well, I'm sure there'll be 100 variants. But it's the disc that interests us. So what do we get? 15 stories. Yes, 15, not 14, not 13. You get the 13 episodes which make up the whole of that series, plus the Christmas special, plus Time Crash. Again, you're thinking, but I already own these because I have the vanilla versions. Now, I was going to do an entire series for overview. However, those nice people over at Podshock will be having one of those great phone-in shows where we can all discuss that sort of thing. And I, for one, will be attending that very shortly. So right now, what I'm going to discuss are the extras and the box set itself. I suppose you could see that Time Crash itself is an extra, if you really wanted to do that. I know it's only 10 minutes long, but to me it was absolutely superb. That and Voyage of the Damned make up the first disc. Voyage of the Damned this time having a commentary by Murray Gold, that's the composer for those of you who don't know, Russell Tovey, the man suggested by RTD to play the next Doctor, a lot of people have made far too much of this, and Peter Bennett, the first assistant director. This isn't the same commentary that we had free as a podcast, so it's yet another commentary. It isn't until the second disc that things really pick up, though. The Partners in Crime audio commentary is by Julie Gardner, RTD, and James Strong, that's the director. Fires of Pompeii's audio commentary, it's by David Tennant, Catherine Tate, and Tracy Simpson, she's the production manager. The Planet of the Ood commentary has Graham Harper, director, and Roger Griffiths, who played Commander Kress. The Sontaran Stratagem, that's got Julie Gardner, Dan Starkey, who played Commander Score, and Neil Gorton, the prosthetics designer. Very good, that one. The Poison Sky has David Tennant, RTD, and Susie Liggett. RTD's definitely making more of a presence this year on the commentaries. The Doctor's Daughter has Catherine Tate, Georgia Moffat, Jenny, and of course Peter Davison's daughter.
Hello, Dad.
And Ben Foster, who was the conductor. The Unicorn and the Wasp has Felicity Kendall and Fenella Woolgar, that's Agatha Christie. There's a very good Fenella Woolgar interview on the WhoCast. Silence of the Library, that commentary's got David Tennant, Stephen Moffat, and Julie Gardner. More about that one in a moment. Forest of the Dead, Eros Lynn, that's the director, Louise Page, the costume designer, and Helen Rayner, the script editor. While Midnight has David Tennant, RTD, and Alice Troughton, the director. And I must admit, I for one would like to see Alice Troughton at a convention so that I could give her a t-shirt that says, I'm not related to the other Troughtons. Or just, not related, written on it. That would be great. Because I think everyone will ask her the same question. Turn Left has got Catherine Tate, Bernard Cribbins. How good a commentary with Bernard Cribbins and Jacqueline King. That's Sylvia Noble. It'll just be great.
Donna, the stars are going out.
The Stolen Earth, David Tennant, RTD, and Julie Gardner. More David Tennant than you've ever had before. Journey's End finishes with the classic triumvirate. David Tennant, Catherine Tate, and RTD. But what else do you get, apart from some people talking over something you're trying to watch? Well, the Doctor Who Confidentials. Now, I've got an issue with these, I must admit. They are very good making-of documentaries. They're half an hour long, when you tape them off BBC Three. The problem is, on these discs, they're confidential cut-downs. They're abbreviated versions. Well, that's no good to anyone. You're sitting there going, and don't I remember something else? If you want to look at it one way, the original Doctor Who Confidential is the nearest to classic Doctor Who we have. An event, television, something that's only ever shown once, it's only ever repeated as confidential cut down. It's very rare that it's repeated in its entirety. And then it's kind of lost forever. So if you don't get it, You won't get to keep it. And we're Doctor Who fans. We like keeping such things. So why bother to put an entire disc, the whole of Disc 6, is Doctor Who Confidential cut down? I would much rather own the full Doctor Who Confidentials because they're very, very good. The extras themselves beyond that are fairly limited. We have a half-hour film called The Journey So Far, which is a documentary that shows how basically the whole show has returned from 2005 right up to the end of Series 4. It's got interviews with Russell T, David Tennant, you know, the usual people. All of the trailers that were shown by the BBC and indeed in the cinema are shown up there. And like last year, we have David Tennant's video diaries. Sadly, this time there's only two of them. The first one being David Tennant's trip to Blackpool to turn the lights on, which is a lot funnier than it sounds. And the last one is some behind-the-scenes footage at the very, very end of Series 4. Both worth seeing. Something that is worth seeing are the deleted scenes. Now, as we all know, Howard Atfield, the guy who played Jeff Noble, Donna's dad, was sadly extremely ill during the recording, and his demise is covered in RTD's latest book. The scenes with him in were recorded at the time, and the guy really doesn't look well, because those deleted scenes are included here. They're introduced by RTD, and there's a lot of additional footage. We also have the original Cyberman ending for the Series 4, and if you include that mentally with the rest of Series 4, it does give you a whole different emotional journey. It was right to be removed. Other stories that have additional material are Voyage of the Damned, Partners in Crime, Fires of Pompeii, Planet of the Ood, The Doctor's Daughter, The Unicorn and the Wasp, Forest of the Dead, Turn Left and Journey's End, all well worth looking at. So is this worth buying? Well, if you own the vanilla versions, perhaps you should always consider not getting this, but if you've been hanging on to buy this, then yes, go for it. The commentaries are superb, and it'll be a welcome addition to your shelves. There are a few things mentioned on the commentaries that I wouldn't mind mentioning in passing. Now, obviously, we've covered David Tennant's news this week, but on the commentaries, he does refer to Steven Moffat as his new boss. Which is fair enough, because in many respects, he is. Steven Moffat also tells us how much he loves his two-parters. I mean, let's face it, if you're an old-school fan, you still like cliffhangers. But it really won't affect how much he works on the show. Of course, they are joking a little bit with each other when they're asked about the title sequence for Series 5 and whether the face should appear, which is of course a reference to the classic series where all of the Doctor's faces used to appear. I've got no real issue with that, as long as nobody winks. There are some giveaway moments where they talk about things coming for the Christmas special. The only thing worthy of note that I really spotted was that the Torchwood set was told to have been trashed for using in the special. But is that the Christmas special or is that one of the later ones? Well, we can assume later. It would be nice to have some sort of Torchwood reference. And with that, I'll bring us to the end of this week's Tin Dog podcast. Next time, I'll be talking about the current BBC 7 series of Doctor Who audios. Yes, if you've got BBC 7, which is a radio station, you can listen to the previously released as CD, Paul McGann's Season. They're extremely good, and they're very easy to download and listen again. I would definitely recommend them. So until then, be seeing you. You have been listening to the Tin Dog Podcast. Doctor Who and its associated shows are all trademark of the BBC. No infringement is intended. Contact us at tin-dog@hotmail.co.uk.
TARDIS has been destroyed. Now tell me, Doctor, what do you feel? Anger? Sorrow? Despair?